everything should be fine. So, with that said, welcome to another live coding show of CodeTap. I'm your host, Marian, and tonight we are going to change our project. We've already started in a previous only YouTube live coding show to work on the quick block. There's nothing that much done to it. However, there was an idea that I had in my head, which I made it happen. So we'll continue from over there. For those ones that are new to this show, let me quickly remind you that almost all the movies, but the one previous to this one, so all the movies are nicely organized in playlists, which you can find on YouTube. So all you have to do is go on this link, not YouTube escape, no, yeah, so this link, youtube.com/codetap/playlists, and you can find them nicely organized. And well, follow along. I no longer need this, so let's see, tab, bye. And if you're watching from Facebook, that's cool. If you want to watch this live stream in 1080p 60 frames per second, well, follow that link on the screen and join the live show live stream on YouTube. And also, let me remind you, tata dă-mi perna, te rog. Mulțumesc. Let me remind you to subscribe to YouTube. And a quick way to do that is follow this link, codetap.io/YouTube, to subscribe on YouTube. Thank you. With that said, let's go back to our code and let's see where we are at. So right now, if I am to resize this a bit, no hand, let's see how much I can resize it. Yeah, that should be fine. So if I zoom in, does it work? Yeah, it does. So I've created a loop and basically I printed both buttons over here, and when you click on one button, notice that the color of that text changes. So what we've done is we are targeting the root color dark. Let me get to the CSS part of it. So I think it's here, yeah. So I got root, we got color dark and color normal. So we are targeting the color dark and change it with JavaScript. And once we change it, it changes everywhere in the website. And this here is just like an example to see the basic concept working. So it's like, later on I'll create like a navigation, a theme selector. And based on that theme selector, you click, it expands, and then you get some buttons that you can click on, and once you click on that button, the entire website changes with that color. Yeah, so I'll see about it, but basically that's our aim. So this is where we are at. Let's see if we have this already online. So github.com codetap.io, and let's see, yeah, codetap blog. So there are four commits, and let's quickly have a look at it. So basically this is the bare project when we clone it from pack starter, and then we made it a quota block, and then we initialized the src index pug and the style scss. So nothing that fancy so far. And then we added some titles, so we created the layout. So this is index pug, and it extends the layout, which is this one. And then play with JavaScript and some colors. So basically we added those colors in. So you can switch themes. So that was our intent, yeah. So this is what we've done. Okay. So right now, I want to find the nice theme online, because in the description, let me bring the description up. So how do I get quickly there? It's live, right? codetap.io/live. Yeah, no, it's not. However, I'll get to it in just a second, because I forgot to do that part. So select the minus. Yeah, that's it. Copy it. Let me also open key pose so you can see what keys I'm pressing. So that means I'll open P agent, and in P agent I'll say add key and select my private key, my SSH key, and then I'll open this party thing which connects to my server. So when I have a shortcut elive, which basically says to edit this file, and then I'm gonna search for the question mark, and then once I get it I press I for interactive mode, and then start deleting some of those ones, and then right click and paste whatever I copied earlier, the idea of the movie. So now right quit means save and quit, and let's see if live now takes us to the live feed. Yes, hey Razvan, did you type something here, guys? How is it going? I'm excited about this. I am too, Razvan. So yeah, well, let's see some infinite looping here, infinite image looping. So anyway, dun, dun, dun. I was saying in the description over here. So in the description we have how to make use of any template on the web for free. So basically we will look at for templates and start replicating the features that we want, grab paddings, margins, colors, whatever we need. So let's start to do that, and later on we'll continue building this blog, the very minimum required to have it online, and then start writing content with each live show or offline tutorial that I do. So basically it will be like an address book of my future and present videos, of CodeTap future and present videos. And then all the build that we do for this blog will be to a certain degree with the mindset to easily migrate it to a JavaScript solution like React, Redux, Firebase. So as soon as it gets too complicated to be maintained with PUG and with our current structure, or at least it doesn't offer features that you can easily do with HTML, CSS, and or basic JavaScript, then we'll migrate it over and we'll see how it goes. So right now it's not about building stuff with either HTML, PUG, CSS, SAS, or JavaScript. It's about being agnostic to technology to a certain degree and choose whichever offers us the best value. For example, which enables us to have it online as quickly as possible without any issues and without spending too much time. That's the solution that we chose, and that's the PUG starter one, the one that we write HTML, CSS, and maybe some JSON, and basically we got our website on. There is a tick coming from one of those things. If you can hear the tick, do let me know. I do hear it and it's a bit annoying. So I'm pretty sure you might not hear it, but let's hope you don't. It's like tick 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 tick. I hate it. Anyway, so now, do you know any websites with themes? Do you recommend any of them that have really clean and neat themes, usually to buy or free, doesn't really matter. All I know right now, it's either template monster, I don't know exactly how to type it, so usually I Google it, and basically over here there are some themes and clean blog. Let's see if you can find some nice ones. That's cool. If not, we'll try some other ones. Okay, if you have any suggestions, drop a link on Facebook. I'm pretty sure YouTube is not friendly with links being dropped on the chat. Let me quickly refresh the Facebook one so I can easily see if you're saying anything. Nope.
It's not friendly with.
Come on, mute. Yeah, done. Hey Radu, Chokoyu, how are you? So I was just reading a video chat of Facebook. So on Facebook you can drop links. I'm pretty sure you can. So any suggestions of any cool theme we should look at? Well, this one looks nice, but let's see if it's not too much into cleaning. Live demo. What's this one? No, I don't want anything from you. It's quite clean, not perfect definitely, and then let's see if we resize it how it behaves. Is this okay? That's cool. So it looks okay so far, but not it didn't impress me much, so arrange that monitor. So no, it did not impress me much. This contrast over here is very poorly. I'm not gonna fix it. I'm looking for a template that's already looking nice. So definitely this one is clean. It's a good choice for somebody else, not for me. So let's see anything else. There is also like theme forest. Yeah, theme forest. If we can't find something here, because apparently it went into cleaning. Come on guys, I was like clean theme, not cleaning. So let's try theme forest. Okay, no suggestions. Radu Choko is asking if I only do HTML CSS tonight. Well, tonight I'm looking for a theme. So I'm going through the process of starting my blog, and I tried not to hide anything. So like you guys should know how I do about it. Maybe you can learn something out of it anyway. But the point is find the theme. And once we do that, quickly plan the very, very minimal change that we want to do to our blog to make it live. And basically that's the plan for tonight. It might not have any coding at all. We don't know. At the moment, I'm looking for a theme. So theme forest. Let's hope this one is better. So blog. Ooh, there's some tags here. Can I click on them? Okay, blog and clean. I like this. It's promising. Now, how do I sort it? So 134 ratings. Let's blog WordPress blog. Well, let's have a look at it. I don't like that word WordPress, but well, it's my own opinion. You can like WordPress as much as you want. I won't hold grudge for it. Okay, why is it jumping so much? Well, this one definitely is for the moment the first choice. How do you close this stuff? Yeah, maybe that's why. So anyway, it's the first choice and it looks clean. Definitely, I don't like this big thing here. I might start like this with the menu already on the top. I don't like that, losing this much real estate, but so far it looks clean. There's a clearer separation of elements inside. Definitely quite easy to read. Let's see if they have any effects so far. So the footer is also a nice one. Not outstanding, but quite nice. Let's see what options they offer here. Right sidebar post. Something else. Pages. Left background header page. Nothing to contact me. Let's see. What do you think, guys, so far about this one? I like it, but I want to look at least one or two more before I jump to conclusions. Okay, so it also has this nice thing over here. Hmm. What else does it have? Maybe I don't know how to navigate this. Really? What do you people look at? Ah, video post. Let's see how it looks. Okay, this is from Vimeo. That is just a normal post, but okay, it has some tags here, the share button, then the offer, I think. This could be, yeah. So some nice ideas over here, definitely. Not interested in this kind of comments over here. Maybe in the future, if I do anything, I'll see about those comments, but definitely not interested in somebody typing their email in here and name and whatever. Definitely not. The way I would do it is maybe implement a feature so you can log in with either Facebook, Twitter, Gmail, GitHub, because we are coders. Possibly customize one, but if you don't have one of these, something wrong with you. I don't try to limit it, but I'm not saying use Facebook but or Gmail or whatever, but if you don't have one of these, definitely something wrong with you. So anyway, so far it looks clean. I'll hold this like right here and let's look for another one. I think this might be the same thing. Smart blog. This is smart. So let's see how smart is this smart one. Okay, remove frame. I don't like that the typography that much, but that can be easily changed. However, this looks nice. Yeah, it's not bad. This drop down over here. Let's see. Again, I don't want to lose that much state over here. I'll probably start maybe like this. Anyway, I'll see about it. But this one is a clean one too. Although this contrast over here between the background and it's, I don't like it. So that's a thumbs down for me. I like it because it's not easy for the reader to easily identify the elements. And if it's not easy for the reader, then yeah. It's not easy for you, it's not easy for me, then you get bored or you might leave the site just for this and miss out the great content that I'm or you or me are trying to give to you. So yeah, it's a clean one, definitely. Let's quickly see just for a second how we would it look if it would be a background F8. Okay, let's do, I don't know, CCC. Just for the sake of it. So I'm not saying that this is the right color, but look at it. This is a post, that's the background. This is another thing, that's the background. So yeah, there's a clear separation. So it's clean. I'm not gonna go for this one. Let's see if you guys have any suggestions. So thank you, Jeffrey Cairo. You're amazing too. Jeffrey Cairo. CSS Zengrade. Let me quickly have a look at CSS Zengrade. Zengrade, not garden. CSS Zen Garden, not grade, but whatever I was reading. So how do we find the themes here? View with all designs, yeah. Yeah, let's see this one. The beauty of CSS design. This is something I like. However, there's a thing here that's not good about it. Because this is even better. This tends to be quite minimalistic. It's definitely my thing, but I'm trying to address my users, and usually my users don't go for those kind of designs. They want to see something, but definitely quite good one. Thank you. Thank you for your suggestion. I used to browse this one long time ago, but it was not in my mind right now. This one is a good one. It's easy to read. It's quite simplistic though, so I might go for it or not. This is like a second choice so far. It's easy to read and easy to do. I would like this one to be nice. It looked nicer earlier, but let's see how it behaves when we resize it. Okay, so not something amazing, but anyway. This would be nice to be nice, but when you make it bigger, it's not looking nice to me. However, did I save the other one? Which one was it? Was it this one? I think it was this one, yeah. So this one is another choice. So this is my first choice. This is my second choice so far. Thank you guys for your good suggestions. Let's quickly see if, because I don't want to spend forever here. Just like have two, three, four of them to choose from and then go for one. Mm-hmm. This is like a ticking bomb. Can you hear it? I hope you do. Something wrong with you. Not something that jumps. Definitely not this. No, bye bye. So I'll keep that. I'll keep this. And let's look for. Have we looked at this one? Yeah, we looked at this smart dog. Sarah. Fastblog. Hey, Fastblog. It's like quick blog, fast blog, almost the same in the same vicinity. Does it have a live preview? What's Weber? Maybe I didn't click. Okay, fast blog. Live preview. Ooh, dark. Dark. Nah. Not for me. It's not about dark, I thought it. Come on, maybe it has a live version, light version. Does it have one? Yeah, let's see. See, this theme switcher, but it's not like that ugly to switch. This is something similar to the idea that I was talking earlier. So once you click on both ones, it changes the theme. But if you see, it just changes it. It changes on the fly. So yeah. Anyway, let's get back to it. This one requires a page refresh or whatever it does here. The idea is similar. So far, I closed the wrong thing. So what's theme forest? I'll look for another one and then stop looking. So blog, and then there was a tag thing here. Blog clean, done. Okay, now let's see. Minimal clean WordPress blog, Uber blog. Let's see. Live preview. This one again has, I see it difficult to separate the elements, so it's hard to follow. Uber blog. Lots of images. See? Look at this one. I'm just saying, like, it's not a tremendous improvement, but look, you can definitely make a quicker sense. Where is this element ending? Where's the background? See? Definitely better than the other ones. So, yeah, maybe if any of you are designers, keep that in mind. Make things for users, not for yourself. I guess I'll, I don't know, I don't see any other one. Fashion blog, let's see, maybe this is something nice. We only got two so far. I hoped I'll get, no, I don't like it. Is it that hard to find a blog? Blog and magazine. Live preview. How do you go, guys, about it? How do you choose your theme? I'm pretty sure you want to start from scratch and I don't know, dream about it. You might dream about it. Sometimes you do, but not all the time. How do you choose your theme? Drop a comment below. Let us know. Maybe. Wow. This is so ugly. I don't like it. I'll stop here. So we got CSS, Zen Garden, and Golden Snow Land. Let's put them side by side for a second. Okay, this is one. And then this is the other one. Resizing windows. Not my favorite. Not my cup of tea. Come on. Yes. One was there. No. Really? It's like I don't know how to resize the window. Come on. Yeah, that's it. Done. What happened to the other one? Who made it big again? Yes, go. Finally. Side by side. Okay. Let's see now. Let me read the comments. Ah, this one went big too. Everything went big. It's like, what? Come on, window manager. Okay. Thanks, Daniel. Hey, Daniel. Daniel was saying excellent work. So now let's see. More easy clean. Yeah, I'll go for easy clean maybe later on. Should I go for easy clean now? Drop a comment if you want me to go and look for easy clean themes, maybe, because we only have two of them and maybe we can find another one. Salve, subscribe, and Krakzapro. Thanks guys for subscribing. So maybe it's time, as a reminder, subscribe on YouTube, and an easy way to do that is to follow this one. This link, codetap.io/YouTube, or just go on YouTube, search for CodeTap and subscribe it to yourself. That's like a shortcut. Okay, and another one. So, 4 subscribers. Thank you, guys. You're amazing. So, let's see. Go for most expressive one. Which one, Garcia, which one do you think is most expressive out of those two so far? The one on the left, Golden Snowland, or the CSS in Garden? I'm not a designer. Guys, I'm not a designer. Definitely not a designer. I'm so, my let's see, artist skills are very, very low. However, I'm good with Photoshop. I can replicate any design, most effects, even complex ones. If you let me know what you want, I can do that, but it's not my cup of tea. I'm not an artist. I can do amazing things if I'm pointed to the right direction. So just to spell it out there, I'm not an artist. Maybe with coding, but not like colors and whatever. I prefer the left one. CodeTap has a blog already? No, CodeTap does not have a blog. And basically, I in my blog, I want to keep like a diary of everything we do with CodeTap. And I want to start working on CodeTap and the 404 pages with so many people suggested that I should fix them. So I don't want this work not to be, recorded in the diary or my blog. So firstly, build a very minimal blog where I can start writing articles, and each time I do something, I write about it, so it will be easier for other people to follow. So yes, the simplest blog, build it and then start doing something about CodeTap and other courses. And by the way, there's lots of changes happening right now. There's like around the room, there's painting going on, and other, let's say, buildings, not buildings. So there are changes going on because I'm gonna start some new shows with my son and so on, and also about the coding ones. I'm gonna change a bit the theme to be more showy, let's say. So I'll increase the showness or the show level, so it will be more fun, more exciting, more engagement, and definitely easier for you to relate to it. So yeah, this ticking bomb is driving me crazy. So yeah. Okay, Garcia, so I think I've seen already lots of people saying something about the Golden Snow Land in the chat, so I'll go for this one. I do like this one too. This is more like newspaper, or at least it gets me to that idea, like an old newspaper, and it's quite nice. I like this one too. Definitely, I like it. So I don't know. I'll keep this in mind. Keep this in mind. Okay, Swiss. Bye bye. Okay, I'll keep this one. This is our choice for tonight. So how do we start replicating some of this? Firstly, I will identify what I like about it, and I like both ones are quite easy to do over here. I don't think I have Pinterest yet, but I'll ask Graziella if she hasn't created an account yet. Maybe she'll create now. So I have a Facebook, Twitter, YouTube, Instagram, and possibly I have one about Pinterest. I'm not sure what I could post on Pinterest about coding. Do coding people post on Pinterest? I don't even know how to spell it. But anyway, both are easy to do. I think we've covered this like in at least two or three of our previous projects on how to implement icons. Let's blog. This one goes away so quickly. So quick it goes away. And then what's this? This might be like a share thing. Yeah. That's a nice idea. Where does it take you? Okay, if I click on Twitter. Okay, so it's nice. It's nice. And then this search. We won't have a search in this blog, so to start with. And I'm not sure about this is more maybe related to the theme itself, or no, it's like a quick menu. Nice one. What do you think, guys? Should I have the menu like this one? It's not something I'm very happy about it. Definitely not something I'm happy about it. Or a suggestion is either on click or on hover. I think hover is better. Or click as a backup, maybe for mobile or tablets, because you can't hover, or at least not unless you have like a pen. And so for those ones will be like a fallback, the click. So once you hover, a menu come over from over here. I see this more fancy than the traditional menu. What do you think, guys? What would you like to see me building? So the rest of the theme looks nice. Let me add favorites. So this is what we are going to go for. Okay. Yeah, this is what we are going to go for. So let's see how we're doing with time. We've already spent half an hour looking for it. And basically this is what you should also do, but sometimes it takes more than half an hour. Sometimes it's just crazy. Especially when you have clients that don't know exactly what they want and they kind of give you suggestions. I would like it to look a bit like the header from YouTube. And do you know Facebook? That side thing on the Facebook, and there is something on Pinterest that I really like to have. And they give you so much information, but sometimes they're not those websites that you already know, so you have to, you know, suck it and do it. Yeah, I like this one. Starting with an image. Is this a good idea to start with an image? It could be a good one. or not. But definitely I like this one. So guys, I'll quickly give you a preview on what we'll be starting to do soon. So basically, this is the process that I usually go through. As soon as I identify an element or a component, which a component is basically a group of elements that somehow define a simple idea, for example, like a menu, that would be a component, or maybe, let's see, this would be a component as well, this sharing part, or this one showing art, food, music topic, and with this horizontal rule, this might be a component as well too. Both of them. So anyway, as soon as I identify it, I start click, I inspect it. Let me zoom in a bit for you guys. And then I start clicking on those elements in here to understand how it was built and can I improve it on the fly. So if I am to start replicating this, can I improve it without having so many tags or so many classes, whatever. So if I can improve it, basically I take the idea out of it and then I look in here. Let's find something. I look for rules, and in those rules I look for colors, background colors, font size, border radius, whatever it is. I look for it. If it's not done with CSS and I can do it with CSS, then I will not do it without CSS. I will definitely do some effect or some feature with CSS if it can be done. If not, I'll look into, can I do it with SVG? Can I do it with JavaScript, with image, whatever. So that's the process that I go through. I start inspecting those ones. I start studying how they are built and start replicating it myself. Usually for colors, I just grab it from over here. I don't even spend too much time about thinking about something else. Let's see. For example, for this H1, let's find some color. And where is a color? Come on. Really? No color. I've seen some earlier. But for example, this one, lots of 222. So I just grab it from over here, then name that color. Paste it in here. And then I have even a nice name for it, Mineshaft, and use it in my project. That's how I do it. Then I also, you can easily go on computed over here, and then you can see if it has any paddings, borders, margins. You can so easily see them. If it only has on one side like this, you can see it like that, and it's easy for you to see it. The box model, like. And then if you learn to use this computed, unless you pay attention or unless you know you're quite good with CSS, you're gonna run into some issues, which are rules overriding other rules and other rules and so on. So you might have a color of white and then overwritten by black and then by red and then by gray. So at some point one of them wins, and CSS specificity tells you which one is gonna win. But over here in the computed one, if you don't really care about all this work going on, you're gonna get the last one, so the one that wins. So you wouldn't even see that one was overwritten by the other one, and when you see it crossed in the inspector. Over here you just see the one that is available on the website. So also like font sizes and so on, those can have a word of themselves too. So yeah, and now at some point, well, this one doesn't have too much. Carol was mentioning, a student of mine was mentioning that Firefox has a neat way to grab the JavaScript that's attached to that element, like click events and so on. And well, I think he was talking about something like this over here, like the event listeners. Although this one doesn't have any click attached to it, but anyway, you can find more stuff attached to this element over here. And if it's not the same thing, well, it's close enough. But this is what I was chatting with him back then. So anyway, this is how I do it. I start inspecting stuff. I see what fonts they have. I see what icons they have. colors, paddings, margins, and then I start replicating, because I'm not a designer and I don't want to deal with the process of creating this. It's already created for us. If you want to go quicker, go and buy it. But if you want to learn how to build it, or at least don't want to pay for it, it's easy to just inspect everything and start building your website. And then give thumbs up to the guy that built this theme, because he spent some time into it. But as I'm doing all my content for free, there'll also be some paid content. So basically, this guy over here, he'll earn from the ones that are lazy and want to pay. And basically that's how it will happen for me too. You can get all the content for free as long as you spend the time to go through the lessons. If you want something let's say more condensed, and I'll have to spend some of my own time especially for that, so that's gonna be paid. You have the free content and the paid content. One takes half an hour to look through, one takes 5 minutes. So now, yeah, it's one and the same. So yeah, that's how I do it. Unless some client pays for it, I'm not gonna pay for it. Definitely, because I don't even want to use the structure that he built. I'm just gonna use the looks that this guy built. And the looks are looking great. Let's see if there are any questions, guys, so far about this process, about looking for themes, starting your own project. If you have any suggestions, if you have anything that's not clear, let me know and I'll try to answer them. Otherwise, this would be for tonight. I've chose my theme. Thank you guys for being part of this process and suggesting and helping me choose it. And tomorrow night we'll start coding. We'll start coding our blog and hopefully have a very simple article already up there. So let's read the chat now. Dun, dun, dun. So Daniel is commenting on Facebook. However, on Facebook you can't see the feed happening on the live show. So he's saying that he has a very similar process of going on the web and visiting lots of examples and then choosing from those ones. Now let's see how I can make this YouTube chat bigger so I can read more of it. No, isn't it? About chat. Yes. Now it's bigger. I can definitely and easier read it. It's good for SEO. If you put full screen check in the line, there is a continuing need to show the part of CSS. Then it's good for SEO. Definitely, I would say from my own experience about the CSS Zen Garden that they are good for SEO. Their web page load very fast, they're well structured. I think they also apply to most of the SEO rules, like the anchor tags have titles, the images have alt tags, alt attributes, and maybe width and height set, and well, it's nice structure. So usually if you go for a theme from CSS Garden from the old times, that I like 8 or 10 years ago that I used to look at them, they were building quite nice themes and well structured, so it will definitely help you for SEO. Can you put the volume a little bit up, please? Now let's see. I increased the volume, and now let me know if there is any change in the volume. I'm also speaking a bit closer to the microphone, but let's hope my head doesn't get cut from the image. Quite soon I'll have a set of two microphones, so it will better pick the sound, hopefully. Thanks, Daniel, for your input. So guys, if you don't have any questions, I'll wrap this up. I'll give it a bit more for you to maybe think of something, but this is how I start my personal websites or websites that I built for free for others. Unless somebody pays for the theme, I'm not gonna pay for it. And my reason is not because I don't want to pay for it, it's because I would not be able to use the theme as it is already done. I have my own style, which is definitely not this style of building web pages. I tend to use as less HTML tags as possible. Maybe if I'm lazy, I drop one or two more in, but this one is like so many HTML tags. I also tend to write the CSS using OO CSS, which is object-oriented CSS. Let me quickly show you, so it's like SMAX. Okay, this one, scalable and modular architecture of CSS. And there is another one, BEM. See, so methodologies like OO CSS, SMAX, Swift CSS, Atomic. Anyway, all those ones help you write better CSS. And if you know any of those ones, on top of knowing some other stuff, basically you get clients that pay better because you build websites that are well structured and they are looking for people that at least have knowledge about this or not. The experience is good to have, but not necessarily. But when you're asked about how do you better structure the CSS and you name at least one of those ones, well, you have like a thumbs up, not a thumbs down. So I might, in my blog, I also plan to do some of the JavaScript or CSS challenges that I get for interviews. I go to interviews quite often. Even if I have a job, I still go to interviews to feel the market, to see what's out there, maybe better opportunities. This is who I am. So I'll share with you some of those, let's say, tests. And some of the ones related to CSS that I'm just gonna search for them and share them with you. Well, you can get paid pretty good only for CSS, and people don't really believe that much in CSS. It's like £500 a day if you're good with it. So that's a lot. Now, don't ignore CSS, don't ignore HTML, and don't ignore JavaScript. Try to understand how the browser works and not be too much, oh, I'm Angular fan or I'm whatever, React fan. Well, learn how they work and what one has better than the other one, so you can make a better judgment whenever you're gonna start building a project. It's not about being cool with JavaScript or being cool with CSS. It's about what's the best outcome, what's the best choice, given that all of them have pros and cons. So right now, I would not start to build my my blog using React, definitely not, because it will take too much time compared to starting it with PackStarter. If I would not chat with you online, well, it will be already done by this time. So I'm sharing this with you, and if I would start it in React, I would definitely not be at the same level as starting with this one. So get it out. Get like the minimal viable product, MVP. I was so long didn't know what this means, or IP, intellectual property, whatever. So I didn't know what MVP means. It means get something out, share it with your possible audience, clients, friends, family, see how they react to it. Because if you're so, let's say, sideways from your target and you can find it this sooner rather than later, well, then you can improve on it. You can change something and make it better. Or you can, at least if it's that bad, you can say, well, I'll start from scratch with some other new idea. So don't spend too much time on it, on anything. Get something quick out. Let it be out there for your users, for your audience, and see what they have to say about it. That's what I'm planning to do right now. I'm planning to teach you and show you so many times, so you get in your head, that the reason that I choose the box starter, which is HTML and CSS only, it's only because it's quicker to prototype something. 10, 50 articles later on in my blog, if I decide that it's too much of a hassle and it's time for me to search for a new idea, for a new solution, I might go to JavaScript or maybe whatever we'll be doing later on, Go, or Laurentius suggesting something like, what's the other thing? It's missing from my mind, Laurentius, maybe you can remind me. The thing that Microsoft is going to come out with, like some new processor, I forgot the name of it anyway. If you're listening, maybe you can drop a comment over there. But anyway, if something cool is out there and it's new, we're gonna do it. Yeah, Quantum Laurentius, thank you. I'm not sure if it will help us or not, but I'm hearing lots of good things about Go or some other languages, so we'll see. Let's have some fun. Thank you, Garcia. Thank you. So, yeah, this is it. This is it for tonight. I'll wrap this as I don't see any questions going on. So, I'll see you tomorrow night. My aim is to do those live shows earlier rather than later. However, right now, as I was mentioning, there's lots of work to do here to switch to the new look and feel about the live shows. So, sometimes I have to, well, go out and deal with the outside world. But a good thing for you to take related to CSS is this. The other one was mentioning this one and another one. So let me quickly, bam, CSS, yeah. So this one over here, this is Max, the one earlier, see? And, oh, CSS, I'm not sure what this can talk about, but you can read some more about it. It's basically related to naming and how you think about CSS. Maybe start like with a layout and then go down into components and maybe modifiers and whatever. See, block, element, modifier. Anyway, it will definitely help you write better code, build better websites, advance in your career. And I've already started to work on the plan for React and JavaScript. I haven't forgotten about you guys that voted. I'm working on a very big plan. It takes time for me to get it right. It's basically a course of over 100 lessons. So once I finish with the plan, my aim is to do it in 1 year. However, let's see if I can do it, because it takes time to build something, to record it, to, well, edit it afterwards, create the thumbnails, create content like description, upload it, promote it, subtitles also, like in English at least, and maybe other languages if anyone wants to help. So it's lots of work, and I'm pushing as much as I can do. I already have an assistant to help me out, so I'm looking for a second one just to speed things up. And let's see how much my pocket can sustain it. So far I'm good. So lots of amazing stuff is going to happen. Okay, wrapping this up, guys. You've been amazing for watching this. And as always, happy coding and create something awesome. Stop. Where's the other one?